Swayam Prabha, Digital India, Educated India.
Namaskar and a very warm welcome to all present here today in the second series of lectures on Japanese language and culture. So in our previous lesson, we studied particle ni. We learned how to use particle ni with time. We also did particle o and honorific o. So there is a big difference between the two, as you already know now. Particle o is used to show the object in the sentence, and the honorific O is used to show politeness, to show respect, though the sound, the pronunciation is the same. Syllable is different. Now, we did ni, as you know. We are going to continue with ni, see how ni is used in various ways in the language. Today, we will do with two different verbs. You will see how ni is used over there, and then also we will do with animate and inanimate, how to show existence of people and of objects using ni. Basically, we will see prepositions today. We will learn prepositions. So let us see what we have in our lecture. Now, how do you use prepositions in Japanese? For example, something is on top of another thing, or is behind something or someone, or is in front or alongside something. So how are we going to say these things in Japanese? Let us see. So from the picture, you can see very clearly there is a kaban, there is a bag over here, and there are two people. So the question is, kaban wa doko desu ka? And the answer would be, which is given over here, is kaban wa koko desu. A-san is saying that kaban wa koko desu because it is close to A-san. Now B-san could easily say kaban wa soko desu because it is far away from him. Now there is another way of saying the same thing, kaban wa koko ni arimasu. Why do we use this verb arimasu? Because desu is not a complete verb. It is made with the help of de particle and the su part of the mas form. So it cannot perform all the activities a verb is supposed to perform. All the conjugations cannot be done. So we need a proper verb over here, and this verb shows existence of inanimate objects. That is where a certain thing is present. It is there. The existence of the bag is shown by arimasu. And where is the bag? Is shown by particle ni. A very, very different usage of particle ni. You haven't done this so far. You have only used it with time. So, koko ni. Basically, something wa place ni arimasu. It exists at this place. This is what we did last time. Now today, as I told you, we are going to do postpositions, that is prepositions in English. So what are those postpositions in Japanese? Well, kaban wa mae ni arimasu. If I remove this watashi no from here, we can say kaban wa mae ni arimasu. It is in front. We are not mentioning what it is in front of, but we are saying kaban wa mae ni arimasu. From context, you can understand what is being said. If you add watashi no, then it is very clear I am here and the kaban is in front of me like this. So kaban wa watashi no mae ni arimasu. Mae means front. Instead of kaban, you can have any other noun over here. Instead of watashi, you can again have otosan, okasan, no mae ni arimasu. Now, look at this picture over here. Tanaka-san, we can call him Tanaka-san. He is pointing at this ball. So, what is he saying? Ball wa watashi no mae ni arimasu. It's in front of him, right in front of him. So, ball wa watashi no mae ni arimasu. Or, he can also say, ball wa, this is the table. So, well, tsukue no ue ni arimasu. Tsukue no ue ni arimasu. It is present on top of the table. So, over here also, you can replace mai with ue. So, kaban wa watashi no ue ni arimasu. Sounds very funny, but this is just for practice. So, we can replace mai over here with other prepositions. Ue means up or ahead or top. Okay, so now what are the normal prepositions that we do in English? So, ue, which is up. Shita, which is down or under or below. Or naka, which is inside. Or soto, which is outside. Or mae, which is front or ahead. Ushiro, which is behind, back, etc. So, ue, shita, naka, soto, mae, ushiro. Some very simple postpositions that we are going to take up here. Also, you can use yoko, which is alongside something. For example, you have a wall. Something is parked over here. The cycle is parked alongside the wall. So, yoko ni arimasu. So, we'll see and revise over here. So, Tanaka-san wa asoko ni imasu. He is pointing and Tanaka-san is far away from both of them. We can see very clearly from this word asoko, which means over there. Now, if Tanaka-san was somewhere here, say, then soko ni imasu. Or if he was a little more closer, he could have said koko ni imasu. Or Tanaka-san himself could have said watashi wa koko desu. I am over here. Now, instead of Tanaka, you can replace this noun over here with bucho, which is the head of the department, any section of the office. Then sensei, you already know, chichi and imoto is younger sister. So, someone or something wa place ni imasu or arimasu. You can replace this place over here with jimushitsu, which is the office, working office. Then erebeta no mae, you understand, gakko is school and uchi is house. So bucho wa jimushitsu ni imasu. Sensei wa erebeta no mae ni imasu. Imoto wa uchi ni imasu. Chichi wa gakko ni imasu. Neko wa kuruma no shita ni imasu. Bucho wa kaisha ni imasu. You can also put hon over here. It's an inanimate, non-living thing. So, hon wa Skue no ue ni arimasu. Please remember arimasu and imasu, very important, and ni to show location of the object or person, where the person is. So the place is given, and place ni. Now you can very well see over here, bucho is here, so bucho wa kaisha ni ojimushitsu ni imasu. If this is hana-chan, then hana-chan wa bucho no hidari. Hidari is another locational word, so hidari ni imasu. Hana-chan wa bucho no hidari ni imasu. Tanaka-san wa bucho no ushiro ni imasu. So you can have these words, these prepositions, use and show location of someone or something with reference to something else. I hope it's clear now. Now, we have used ni in a lot of ways. We will show with the help of ni a certain activity at a certain time. For example, watashi wa mainichi 8 ji ni okimasu. So, this activity is being performed at this time, exactly at this time, thus particle ni. Mainichi is time expression, means daily. And watashi wa mainichi, every day, 8 ji ni okimasu. It's a statement. Of course, this says 6 ji, but well, we have used 8 ji over here. So, 8 ji ni okimasu, I get up. So, performing a certain activity at a certain time, exactly at that time, then particle ni is going to be used. And also we did earlier that after time, particle ni is used. 8 ji ni kaisha e ikimasu. Now, another one is here for you. Watashi wa mainichi 6 ji ni tabemasu. Exactly at this time, tabemasu. Not more, not less. Maximum, plus and minus, 2 minutes or 5 minutes maximum, but not beyond. You don't say 6 ji ni tabemasu and you mean 6 ji jugohon ni tabemasu. No, that is wrong. If you say 6 ji ni tabemasu, means daitai 2, 3, 4 minutes here and there, but 6 ji this. Watashi wa ashita 7 ji ni kaerimasu. So, ashita is another time expression, means tomorrow. You already know mainichi ashita, and you will see that with ashita, with time expressions, over here also, particle ni is not being used. Particle ni is being used with exact time, with number and time. There are a lot of time expressions you have done and lot of time expressions which will not take particle ni. Particle ni is not required. Why it is not required? Ni particle is used for exact time. And ashita is a time span, duration. So, this doesn't work over here now. That's why ashita will not take particle ni. Mainichi will not take particle ni. And I will give you a lot of words here which will not take particle ni. You will see yourself. Let's do this exercise also over here. Watashi wa kino 11 ji ni nemashita. Exact time ni nemashita. But kino ni 11 ji ni nemashita? No. 11 ji ni nemashita. Exact time ni nemashita. And this time the watch also tells you 11 o'clock. Let us see what is happening over here. So, watashi wa ototoi okaasan ni denwa o shimashita. Watashi wa ototoi ni? No. Watashi wa ototoi, because ototoi is time span, duration. It's a time expression. It's not exact time. So watashi wa ototoi okasan ni denwa o shimashita. Now this over here, this usage of ni is very different, which I am going to do later. At the moment, please concentrate on watashi wa ototoi denwa o shimashita. So what you have done earlier with o is direct relationship with the verb, noun o verb. The verb is acting on the noun. What do you do with the denwa? You ring up somebody. So denwa o shimashita. Now who did you ring up? It was your okasan. So here the subject, object, subject wa object o verb is very clear. Now we have another indirect object over here. So what do? We cannot have two O's in a sentence. We have done this earlier. O particle, as you know, marks the object in the sentence. So something else has to be done, and that is ni. And what is it equal to in English? It is equal to two of English. Watashi wa ototoi okasan ni denwa o shimashita. In a very different way, you could say I called to my okasan, or you can say watashi wa ototoi okasan ni tegami o kakimashita. So over here the usage of to will be very clear. I wrote a letter to my mother. So this is equivalent to the to in English. I am going to take it up later as well. Watashi wa ototoi denwa o shimashita. Please concentrate on this at the moment, because we are doing time expressions, and time expressions will not take particle ni. Not all, but some of them. So now, what are the time expressions which do not require particle ni? Asa is morning, as you know. Kesa is this morning, konya is this evening, and ima is now. You have done this kanji character also in your previous lesson, which is ima, that inside the house you are sitting and singing now. So this here on top is the hito radical. We just change it a little and make it like this, showing that this is a house. So hito is in the house and singing, and konya this evening, and kesa this morning. Of course, you have ashita tomorrow, kino yesterday, kyo today, and ototoi day before yesterday. So all these will not take particle ni. Also have rainen next year, kotoshi this year, and kyonen last year, and raigetsu next month, kongetsu this month, and sengetsu last month. These time expressions will not take particle ni, because it's not exact time, it is a time span, time duration. Now time expressions where ni is optional. So haru ni, natsu ni, aki ni, fuyu ni. You may add ni, you may not add ni, depending on your sentence construction. Also, if you add ni, there is more stress on what you are saying. You are trying to emphasize what you are saying. That's all. That's the only difference. Otherwise, the meaning, the fundamental meaning of the sentence does not change at all. These are the four seasons you can see. This is aki, fuyu, haru, and natsu. We will do the kanjis a little later. Now there is toki also over here. Toki means time, as you already know, and goro is approximate time. So with goro, either use goro with time or use ni with time. Both are not used, and toki ni is optional. I'll show you later in the lesson. You will know it only emphasizes. That's all. The basic meaning does not change. Now you can see over here, Rainen no natsu, kazoku to issho ni Amerika ni ikitai desu. Or Rainen no natsu ni kazoku to issho ni Amerika ni ikitai desu. It's optional over here, you may or may not use it. In a similar manner, gakko ni ita toki ni yoku sports o shimashita. So when I was in school, I did a lot of sports. I played a lot of games. So when you put ni over here, it emphasizes that at the time when I was in school, I was playing games. That's about all. Without ni also, the sentence is complete. Then, watashi wa ototoi haha ni denwa o shimashita. We just did this over here in the previous slide. This ni over here is 2, which I am going to take up later. Watashi wa ototoi ni again no. Ototoi haha ni denwa o shimashita. I rang up my mother day before yesterday. Or denwa o shimashita is I talked to her. So watashi wa I talked to my mother day before yesterday. So you can see that over here, as I explained earlier, this is the primary object and this is the indirect object of the action. Now we will do how to give and how to receive things in Japanese. The verbs are different for both the cases and they are agemas and moraimas. And the reason why I am doing this over here is because we are going to use particle ni again. So how to use particle ni and what does it mean? Now simple sentence, watashi wa agemasu. I give. So I and give or I gave. Agemashita. Now watashi wa hon o agemasu. I give something. So what do I give? Hon. So watashi wa hon o agemashita. Till now I am not telling to whom. I am just saying that I gave a book or I am going to give a book. Now, watashi wa okasan ni hon or shosetsu, a novel, o agemasu or agemashita. Over here, this ni is equivalent to the English to. So, watashi wa okasan ni, I gave a shosetsu or a hon to, which is ni, okasan, to my mother. So it is watashi wa okasan ni hon o agemashita, this ni over here, after the indirect object, is equivalent to the English to. So I, watashi wa, someone, ni, something. O, something is a noun, obviously. Noun, o, verb. Agemasu. Now, watashi wa moraimasu. So, I am the one who is receiving. Moraimasu is to receive or to get. So, watashi wa moraimasu or watashi wa moraimashita. I received something, I got something. Now, watashi wa hon o moraimashita. As we did for agemasu. I received something. And what is the something? It is a book. Then, watashi wa okasan ni hon o moraimashita. I received a book from my mother. So, this is equivalent to from in English. I, watashi wa, someone ni, which is equal to from, something, o, something is noun again, o, verb, and the verb is morau. So, watashi wa someone ni, something o moraimasu. This is direct relationship and this is the indirect object of the sentence. Now, you can also make it very simple in your mind. Instead of particle ni, you can use kara, which you have done, which is equivalent to from. Watashi wa koko kara soko made. From here still there. Or hachiji kara kuji made. So, this you have done. This means from, and you can use kara over here instead of ni. And remember that with moraimasu, watashi wa okasan kara shosetsu o moraimashita. That's the meaning. With the verb ageru, it means to, I give. And with the verb morau, it means from, I receive. Now, watashi, I give, agemasu. And it's about me. Watashi wa receive, get, moraimasu. I give and I receive. It's all about me in agemasu and moraimasu. Also over here, you can say in place of watashi, imoto, chichi, and haha, wa agemasu. They give something. Chichi wa agemasu, haha wa agemasu, imoto wa agemasu. Okay, something. And again, imoto wa moraimasu, chichi wa moraimasu, and haha wa moraimasu. So you will notice that again, they are giving and they are receiving. Who is giving, who is receiving is not the issue over here. The issue is either I am giving or I can be replaced with this, and imoto or chichi or haha are giving or receiving. It can be sensei also or Tanaka-san, anyone, receiving and giving. So now you can look at this and see, it's very clear. Watashi wa agemasu. B-san ni agemasu. Watashi wa B-san kara moraimasu. Ni agemasu and kara moraimasu. Now, if someone else wants to give something, as I told you just now in the previous slide, so if chichi, haha, or someone else wants to give something to somebody, for example, I want to give to chichi, I want to give to haha, I want to give to tomodachi. It's absolutely correct. Agemasu will be used. If now imoto wants to give to chichi, chichi wants to give to haha, or tomodachi wants to give to another tomodachi or Tanaka-san, then also same agemasu will be used. Or if chichi wants to give something to imoto, or imoto gets something from chichi, haha gets something from chichi or tomodachi, Tanaka-san gets from tomodachi, then it will be morau. We are doing the same thing again and again, so that agemasu and moraimasu with particle ni is very clear to you. Now, if you want to give to somebody who is senior to you, somebody who is older in rank and age to you, then instead of agemasu for politeness and for respect, what are you going to say? Well, it is sashi agemasu. So, to seniors, you will always say watashi wa sensei ni sashi agemasu. Watashi wa bucho ni sashi agemasu. Now, if someone who is senior to you gives to you, then you receive something from your seniors, then what will you say? Watashi wa sensei ni or sensei kara something o itadakimasu. So moraimasu is only for people who are your age. Itadakimasu. Now, imoto wa bucho kara hon o itadakimashita. Or watashi wa sensei kara jisho o itadakimashita. This moraimasu over here is a mistake. When you are receiving something from people senior to you, it is always itadakimasu. Now I will write it down clearly. A gives ageru. A receives morau. B, who is senior to you? A gives sashi ageru, and A receives from someone who is senior in age and in rank. Itadakimasu. Please remember this. Now we have done so much of ni. There is still more ni left. Ni performs a lot of functions in the language. We are going to do another one over here today. How ni shows purpose for going in a certain direction. Now let us see what it is. Watashi wa gohan o tabemasu. You understand? Noun o verb. Now, watashi wa gohan o tabe ni shokudo e ikimasu. So for the purpose of eating, I am going to the shokudo. So it is very clear from tabe ni, tabe masu. Remove the masu and put ni over here. Ikimasu is motion in a direction. When particle ni is added to this verb, then it shows purpose or movement in a certain direction with a purpose. To do a certain activity, which is clear in your mind. So why am I going to the shokudo? I am going to have gohan. So for the purpose of eating, I am going to the shokudo. Person wa, for activity, place a iku. Generally, in this case, the verb is iku. Now, you can use it with other verbs also, like you have ai ni over here, ai masu. So, remove the masu, put ni, or benkyo shimasu, benkyo shi ni, gakko e ikimasu, sensei ni ai ni, gakko e ikimasu. You will notice that the verb is always iku or kuru or kaeru. Now why is that so? Let us see. But before that, let us do a few verbs like tabemasu, mimasu, yomimasu, group 1, aimasu, group 1, this is group 2. So we just need to remove the masu and put ni in place, and it becomes for the purpose of this activity. For example, gohan o tabe ni shokudo e ikimasu. Eiga o mi ni tomodachi no uchi e ikimasu. Or sensei ni ai ni gakko e ikimasu. Or gakko ni ikimasu. Both can be used over here because the purpose is very, very clear. Now, you have shown purpose with the help of particle ni. Now, why we use only motion verbs over here? Because it shows movement or motion in a certain direction and with a purpose. So, what are the motion verbs? You have studied three basic motion verbs, and that are iku, kuru and kairu, and hairu and deru are also motion verbs. Hashiru, which is to run, aruku, which is to walk, and oyogu, which is to swim, also show movement in a certain direction. But why are they not in this motion verb category? Because the motion which is done, or the movement which is done, is of a very specific type. When you walk in a certain manner. So it is not just motion, it is a motion of a certain type. So what is important is that in verb ni construction, the verb will always be iku, kuru or kairu, because it shows movement towards a certain goal. So now how will we say that I am learning Japanese to be able to speak to Japanese people or to be able to know about Japanese culture? Let us see what is the pattern and what form we have to use. So this is what we did just now. Watashi wa nihongo o benkyo shini nihon e ikimasu. Whatever sentence you make, whenever this pattern will come, verb plus ni showing purpose, then the verb is always going to be ikukuru or kairu, which are motion verbs. Now, if we want to say that I am learning Japanese to be able to speak in Japanese, so there is no motion in any direction, so we cannot use this. Now, what are we going to use over here? Watashi wa nihongo o hanasu tame ni, for the purpose of talking, nihongo o benkyo shite imasu or shitai desu or shimasu. Now, one thing you will notice over here is that this verb is in plain form. Hanasu tame ni, for the purpose of talking. Watashi wa nihongo o hanasu tame ni nihongo o benkyo shimasu can also be used. Shitai can also be used. Shite imasu is continuous tense, which means I am studying. Shitai is I want, and shimasu is I will do. The important thing is before tame ni, always verb is going to be in plain form. Now, there's another example for you. Watashi wa nihonjin to hanasu tame ni. I want to talk to Japanese people. Thus, I am doing Japanese for this purpose. So, watashi wa nihonjin to hanasu. Again, you will see plain form. Hanasu tame ni nihongo o benkyo shite imasu or benkyo shimasu. Tame ni is for the purpose of this verb. Now, watashi wa nihon no bunka o narau tame ni, for learning Japanese culture, nihongo o benkyo shite imasu. I am learning Japanese. So over here you will see in these three examples, ikimasu is not given. So you are doing a certain activity for this. The important part is that verb is in plain form. Now, otosan wa kazoku no tame ni hatarakimasu. Till now we were doing verbs. See, over here it is all verbs. Now it is noun. So what is the difference over here? No is added. Kazoku no tame ni, for kazoku. We can replace kazoku with watashi. Watashi no tame ni hatarakimasu, or uchi no tame ni hatarakimasu. So you will notice that with noun it changes a little. This little no is added over here. With verb, the verb is in plain form, and if we are using it in this form, then only ikimasu, kimasu or kaerimasu will be used, which are motion verbs. So very very quickly, tabe ni iki masu, narau tame ni benkyo shimasu or shite imasu. Then kazoku no tame ni hatarakimasu. This is verb, this is verb, and this is noun. So you can see the difference very clearly over here. Tabe ni and narau tame ni and kazoku no tame ni. Now I quickly want to do some kanjis also with you, which we have covered so far. I cannot do all, of course, but yes, some of the easy kanjis. So here we did iku and kuru. So iku and kuru, you come to this crossroad and you don't know where to go. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and you make this umbrella like this, iku. Then we have kuru. So this is ju, you can see very clearly. Then if we just do this, it means white rice, kome, kome. And if we have to write kuru, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. This means kuru. Where is the idea coming from? Well, in jugatsu, ju is this over here, jugatsu, there is rice harvesting. So rice turns red and it's all ready to be harvested. So that's why you can see rice over here. This is the character for rice, and on top you have ju. So like this, kuru. It's given over here, you can see. Then we have ima. You have done ima. Kyo, these are some words with ima. Kyo. You know the words, now you do the kanji. Kotoshi, over here. Kotoshi, which is year. Nen is the other reading for toshi, for this character. Then we have kongetsu. That is like this, ima no month, kongetsu. This is how you would write. There are more words now. Asa, you know, time expression. Asa, like this. With asa, there are some words. Kesa, that is today morning. So, today morning, kesa. Then you have asa gohan. Asa is such, and then you have gohan. Remember doing the honorific go before this character. Now this has become almost a word, and go is not honorific anymore in this. It is just gohan. Nobody says han otabemasu. It is always with gohan. Then asa nebo. So oversleep. Asa is in the morning and nebo is to oversleep. So concentrate only on this part, which is this character, because it's coming from here, asa. Now agemasu is another one that we did just now. Ageru, to give. And this is also the kanji for ue, up. Then you can see we did haru, and haru is very simple. Three people looking at the sun after a cold winter. So that's the pictogram. And 1, 2, 3 over here, here, and then nichi. This is haru. Then we have natsu. Natsu is again like this. You do me, and then this one over here, meaning it's so hot that this person is sitting under the roof, sweating, totally exhausted. That's the pictogram. Then aki, again all the grain becomes red or brown at the time of harvest, which is in autumn for rice, and it's very simple like this, aki. Fuyu, which is like this, a person walking on thin ice. So that's the pictogram. There could be other pictograms as well. These are the pictograms I had. And also look up the net in the dictionary. You can see the stroke order is given very, very clearly, online dictionary. So with this, I would like to finish today's lesson. And we have covered a lot of things here today. We did prepositions. We did particle ni. We did agemasu and moraimasu. With particle ni, agemasu is to give, as you know, and moraimasu is to receive. So giving and receiving in Japanese with particle ni. And then we just now covered some kanjis very, very quickly. All kanjis you don't have to memorize. You can just keep the pictogram in mind and concentrate on those characters. So I'll be giving you a lot of kanjis, but you can pick and choose whichever ones you want and learn and you find interesting. So with this, I would like to end our class today and see you again in our next class. Thank you very much.